الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في قرآنه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. Allah Azza wa Jalla in Quran Kareem saying Muhammad is not a father of anyone of you, but he is Rasulullah, messenger of Allah, prophet of Allah, and Khatam al-Nabiyyin, the last, the end of the messengers. No one comes after him. And we'll stop with, still with the mu'jizat, the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the last time was the miracle of Rasulullah for his dua to the mother of Abu Hurairah, when Abu Hurairah was crying and complaining about his mother to Rasulullah ﷺ that he is trying with her as much as he can for her to be Muslim, but she is refusing, and that time especially she insulted Rasulullah ﷺ. And he went with a good intention saying, Ya Rasulullah, do dua for my mother to be a Muslim right away at the same minute. Because when Abu Hurairah went, find her already taking the shower and saying the shahada. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. First time went with the tears out of sadness. Second time when he went back to Rasulullah with the tears out of happiness. Ya Rasulullah, just a few seconds while you are doing the dua, my mother accepts that Islam. Then he said, Ya Rasulullah, do dua for me and my mother to the believers, to the mu'min, to love me. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did dua for him that every believer will love him and he himself and his mother will love the believers. Then we move to hadith in al-Bukhari, volume number 4, hadith number 3648 and others. When Rasulullah did dua to Abu Hurairah to memorize hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For that the most narrator to hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the one who does not forget was Abu Hurairah by the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to him. Today, about the grandson of Rasulullah, al-Hasan ibn Ali radiallahu anhu, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of the miracle, while he is a child, while al-Hasan was a very young child, said, this one will be a reason for reconciliation between two great groups of the Muslims. Two big group in number of the Muslims. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن ابني هذا سيد الحسن بن علي ويصلح الله به بين فئتين عظيمتين. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, my son, we know this is expression in Arabic, but it is he is real son of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, son of his daughter. He said, he is, Allah will make him a reason to be reconciliation between two big groups in the Muslim. And this is what was happening exactly at the time of Rasulullah ﷺ when the fighting between Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan and al-Hasan ibn Ali was two big groups of the Muslim. One was this side and one was this side and was a lot of killing. Then when he said, I will leave it for you to save the blood. Sayyidina al-Hasan ibn Ali, he is the one who left it to Muawiyah to save the blood, in order nobody be killed, and as Rasulullah says, the reconciliation happened, and this is how many years more than at least 30 years after that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us. Also in the tafasir and in the seerah, seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عن سلمان الفارسي, قال ضربت في ناحية من الخندق. Why they are digging الخندق, that ditch, between the kuffar and the Medina, in order for them not to be able to attack the Medina, and was big number of the non-Muslim at that time. He said, فغلظت علي صخرة. Salman al-Farisi says it was a very huge and very strong rock, and I was not able to break it in order to take it out from al-Khandaq. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very near to me. When he see me doing that and see that this rock was very, very strong, he said, he come down, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he takes the axe from him, and the first time he hit it, out of that hit come like spark from under in between the axe and the stone. Come a spark and very shiny and very big. Then he hit it the second time. Come again the spark and also shiny, and it was very strong. And the third time also the same. فقلت سلمان الفارسي said, بأبي أنت وأمي يا رسول الله ما هذا الذي رأيت لمع تحت المعول وأنت تضرب. He said, يا رسول الله, what I see, it was shiny under the hit of what you did the three times. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أرأيت ذلك يا سلمان. Did you see it? He said, yes, يا رسول الله. قال أما الأولى فإن الله فتح علي بها اليمن. He said, the first one, Allah open the Yemen for me. This is a sign that the Yemen will be open. وأما الثانية فإن الله فتح علي بها الشام والمغرب. He said, the second hit, Allah open for me Sham, with the area of Sham, all of it, not only Syria, and المغرب. Then وأما الثالثة فإن الله فتح علي بها المشرق. He said, the third hit, Allah open the east for me with it. فكان الأمر كما أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على التفصيل الذي قال. سبحان الله, if you looked at the history, according to this three or four places Rasulullah mentioned, it was actually the first one of these, what Rasulullah mentioned, was the Yemen, as Rasulullah said, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then after that, but also later, Rasulullah gives a glad tiding, and was a miracle from Allah to him, at his time, but opening in Sham, was at the time of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. Part of it at Sayyidina Abu Bakr and part of it at Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, but majority at Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. Then after that, the west of the earth and the east of it, exactly as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. وفتح عند وكان ذلك في مدة قليلة بعد وفاة النبي. And this was a very short time after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only this, Khaybar, in order to understand what is Khaybar, it was a fortress. And this fortress was over a mountain like this. Look to me, please. The mountain usually like that. You can climb, right? This mountain was standing like this. And they cut the top and they make it flat. And they make the fortress over it. And with a very high fence. Not only with a very high fence, the mountain like this, and around it there is a lot of soldiers. Anyone who will try to climb, firstly, if he fell down, he will die. Secondly, he will not be able, because at the top they see him, they shoot him. Secondly, that fortress itself is a fence so high and so strong, and also standing very straight. And at the top of it, there is a lot of soldiers of the Jewish. Not only that, the gates of it, impossible to be opened by two, three people, to just open it. If it is locked, impossible to open it. You have to break it. But what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, firstly, it is in Bukhari and Muslim. عن سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم خيبر. This is part of the story, not all of it, because the story of خيبر is long. At the day of خيبر قال لأعطين الراية غدا رجلا يحب الله ورسوله ويحبه الله ورسوله يفتح الله على يديه. He said, tomorrow I will give the flag, means the leadership. The flag means this will be the leader. to the army. I'll give the flag to one of the people of the army to be the leader. Listen, يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. That man, he loves Allah and he loves Rasulullah. Not only that, وَيُحِبُّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ. And Allah and Rasulullah, they love him. يَفْتَحُ اللَّهُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. Because they tried before. One time was not able, they get back. Second time, they get able, they get back. Third time, many times. For that Rasulullah said, I will give it tomorrow to one of you, and it was wahi from Allah to him. That he loves Allah and Rasulullah, and Allah and Rasulullah love him, and Allah will give the victory by his hand. Allah will give the victory to him. When this Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu heard it from Rasulullah, he said, وَاللَّهِ مَا اسْتَشْرَفْتُ وَلَا أَحْبَبْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ فِي مَوْضِعٍ إِلَّا فِي ذَلِكَ الْمَوْضِعِ. He said, by Allah, I never loved to be in any position. Everybody knows that he doesn't like even to be in Khalifa, in Khilafa position. And he was trying to refuse many times. He said, I never ever loved to be in any position except that one. He said, not only that. Why the reason? Because he said Rasulullah, a witness from Rasulullah, that he loved Allah and Rasulullah, and Allah and Rasulullah love him. For that, because of this only, not to be in a leadership, because of that certificate from Rasulullah, he loved it. He said, فَمَرَرْتُ أَعْمَامَ النَّبِيِّ ذَاهِبًا جَائِمًا. He said, I was in front of Rasulullah, try to go and come, try to look to him. While I'm sitting, I try to raise up a little bit. I doesn't want to say, Rasulullah, choose me. Look how they love the word from Rasulullah. He said, I never ever do anything to get any position except in that time only. For that I was going and coming and moving and raising my head and looking to Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the hadith said, فَبَاتَ النَّاسُ يَدُوكُونَ لَيْلَتَهُمْ أَيَّهُمْ يُعْطَاهَا. The whole night everybody was talking, who will get it? فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in the morning, أين علي بن أبي طالب؟ Where is علي بن أبي طالب؟ فقيل هو يشتكي عينين. They said to him, يا رسول الله, he has a sickness in his eyes and he complained about it and he is sick. They said, أرسلوا إليه فأتي به. They sent to him and they come to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. فبصق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في عينيه ودعله. Rasulullah spit in his eye and he صلى الله عليه وسلم did dua to him. قال سيدنا علي, this is the first miracle in it. فبرأت كأن لم يكن بها وجع أبدا. He said it was right away. Have no any sickness and no any pain and was both of them the best. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him the flag. وقال انفز على رسلك حتى تنزل بساحتهم. ثم ادعوهم إلى الإسلام وأخبرهم بما يجب عليهم من حق الله تعالى فيه فوالله لأن يهدي الله بك رجلا واحدا خير لك من حمر النعم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, take the flag, lead the army, go to their places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open it for you, call them to Islam, let them know about the right of Allah upon them, and if Allah guides through you, this is another point for us. If Allah guides through you, only one man, better for you than the Humur al-Ni'am, the red camels, which was at their time the best and the highest and the most expensive one. He said, will be in this hadith saying, will be better for you than the red camels, which at their time was very expensive. Then, when Rasulullah said to him that, and he lead, I already told you, there was too many time before to go and open it and was not able. Even there was before Khaybar too many other also fortress. All of them open except that one was impossible. And in order to know, all of them was having a tunnel under the land to connect from one to another one, and they collect their own selfies in that one especially. Because they know that impossible to open it. When Sayyidina Ali went, narration in this, not in this hadith, they say, only by himself, one of the doors he opened, which it was locked from inside and from outside. Allah make it easy for him to open it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for him to take the Khaybar as exactly Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him. In also one of the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in al-Bukhari, Kitab Fada'il al-Sahaba, Babu Manaqib Khalid, hadith number 3757. And 2,798 and 3,630 and others also. The text of 3757 عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال نعى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زيدا وجعفرا وعبد الله بن رواحة للناس قبل أن يأتيهم خبرهم في غزوة مؤتة. In غزوة مؤتة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم gives the leadership to Zayd. He said, if something happened to you, take it, give it to Ja'far. If something happened to Ja'far, give it to Abdullah ibn Rawah. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, after they left and they went far away, Mu'ta is far away from Medina. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم announced to the Sahaba that already Zayd was killed. Stushhid. Get the Shahada. While before they come and before anybody come until Rasulullah, it was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Rasulullah. Then he said to them, Ja'far already killed. Then he said to them, Abdullah ibn Rawaha already killed. Listen to the hadith. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, firstly, أَخَذَ الرَّايَةَ زَيْدًا فَوْصِيهِ. Zayd, he takes a flag, means he is a leader, then he was killed. Then Ja'far, he takes a flag, then he was killed. Then Abdullah ibn Rawaha, he takes the flags and he killed. And the tears coming out from the eyes of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hatta, Rasulullah said, Hatta akhadaha sayfun min suyufillah, Khalid ibn al-Walid, min ghayri imratin, fafataha Allahu lah. He said, until Khalid ibn al-Walid looked what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the flag was taken by a sword from Allah's sword. Rasulullah named him. A sword from Allah's sword. In this Ghazwa, he fight with 9 different swords. 9. When one broke, he bring another one. One broke, he bring another one. 9 of them. Until he does not find any sword except a piece of metal. He fight with it. Subhanallah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam named him Sayfun min Siyufillah. A sword from Allah's sword. Then he said, without being nominated to be the Amir or to be the chief, and beforehand, Allah give him the blessed with the victory. He was not, because Rasulullah, when he appoints Zayd, then Ja'far, then Abdullah ibn Rawaha, he found out there is no anyone. And there is no any way except he will become the leader. And he was not nominated, but he did. And with the barakah from Allah to him, and with the saying of Rasulullah describing him, Sayfun min Siyufillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened it to him. Imagine 3 before him killed. And not only he does take the army and save himself and the people, no. He goes fighting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, open it to him, but with the time. In al-Bukhari, another miracle of Rasulullah, hadith number 4054 and hadith number 5826 عن سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه. قال رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم أحد ومعه رجلان يقاتلان عنه عليهما ثياب بيض كأشد القتال ما رأيتهما قبل ولا بعد قيل إنهما جبريل وميكائيل. The angels at the day of Uhud was defending and fighting on behalf of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and not only one of the angels, جبريل and ميكائيل. جبريل and ميكائيل is on whom fight. سعد بن أبي وقاص saying, at the day of Uhud, I see 2 people, they come in a form of a human being, 2 people fighting on behalf of Rasulullah and defending him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wearing white clothes, and they fighting with extreme bravery, very extreme and very strong bravery. He said, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, by Allah, I never see them before and I never see them after. Who said that was Jibreel and Mikael is one who was fighting on behalf of Rasulullah. Not only that, Nafi' ibn Jubayr, he said, I heard rajulan min al-ansari yaqulu, shahidtu uhudan ma'a Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fanadhartu ila al-nibali ta'ti min kulli nahiyatin, wa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasatuha, kullu tilka al-nibali tusrafu an. One of the sahaba, Nafi' ibn Jubayr, he said, I heard one of al-muhajirin, he said, I was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I see Rasulullah in the middle, and all kind of different arrow. The arrow is different. Sometimes they name it arrow, which is sahm, sometimes in nabla, and different is some of them long, some of them thick, some of them thin, and different one. He said, I see all kind coming from all different ways toward Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When it comes to near to Rasulullah, it turns somewhere else. Not even one of these swords, or this I mean arrows, touch Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, in al-Bukhari, hadith number 1301, 5470, عن أنس رضي الله عنه. كان لأبي طلحة ابن يشتكي. Abu Talha have his son, was in a deathbed. يعني very near to die. But he was very sick. And his wife named Umm Sulaym. Abu Talha get out for some of his work or whatever. Then, while he is out, that boy, it was near to night, died. His mother was not only herself was so patient. Listen what happened. When his father came back, right away, usually, anyone knows that his son is so sick and he came back to the home, he will ask, how is my son? فقالت هو أسكن مما كان. وفي رواية هدأت نفسه وأرجو أن يكون قد استراح. Look to the word could be understand with two ways. But she means a way to cool him down and not to inform him now that his son is dying. It's night and they cannot do anything. And instead of making put the sadness upon him the whole night till the morning, she said to him that he is more quieter than before. He died. But she said he is more quieter than before. In another narration, he is cooling down and I hope that he will be in a rest forever. Which it is, it could be that two meaning. Get rest forever, he die. She control herself and she prevents the news to go to Abu Talha, to her husband. فقربت له العشاء. She brings the food to him. وتصنعت له فأصاب منها. She beautify herself and he slept with her. فلما أصبح at the morning, قالت إذا أعارك قوم شيئا, if somebody giving you, borrow you something, then comes the time to get it back, will you be angry? He said no, should not be angry and I will return it. He said Allah is the one who give you your son and Allah is the one who take him. Then go bury him. He gets so angry. And he said, you didn't tell me yesterday, and you let me do what I did. Then now you are coming to tell me about that. Wallahi la ukhbiranna Rasulullah. I will go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and let him know about that. He went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told Rasulullah what happened. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a'arastum al-layla. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a nice way and smiling way and very good way. Did you sleep with your wife last night? He said, yes, ya Rasulullah. Look to Rasulullah. He does not say, how? Like some of us put some gas in the fire. Some professional, as you know, PhD in making fire anyway. No. Rasulullah said, Allahumma barik lakuma. Oh, Allah gives him barakah. And another narration, Allahumma barik lahuma fi laylatihima. Oh, Allah gives him barakah in that night. The narrator said, out of the dua of Rasulullah, and this is a miracle. Out of the dua, but we learn a lesson. Imagine that something happened in the house, and some of the wife, some of them is excellent, but some of the wife, little problem. Just the husband come, open the door, screaming, hilarious, no, big problem at that. And it is the problem itself very small. She make it show so huge in order to control. Look to this, her son die. She does not only control herself, she does not let him to know about it until the morning. For that reason, Rasulullah did dua to her. Oh Allah, gives him barakah. How does barakah come? The hadith itself saying, فَوَلَدَتْ غُلَامًا مُبَارَكًا. Number one, Allah give her a blessed boy. After that, then, وَقَالَ أَبُو طَلْحَةَ, he brings that boy to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَبَعَثَتْ مَعَهُ بِتَمَرَاتِ, give him some of the dates. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put it in his mouth. Then, after that, he named him Abdullah ibn Abi Talha. In narration of al-Bukhari, 1301, قَالَ رَجْلٌ مِّنَ الْأَنْصَارِ فَرَأَيْتُ لَهَا تِسْعَةُ أَوْلَادٍ كلهم قد حفظ القرآن عن ظهر قلب. Listen to it carefully. He said, I saw them, Abu Talha and his wife, Allah gives them 9 sons. 9 sons. All of them, without exception, memorize the Quran by heart from the beginning till the end, out of the barakah of the dua of Rasulullah, and her patience, how she deal with her husband. And because of her patience, how she dealt with her husband, and how she respect his right. She does not scream. And even she cry at that night, she has a reason, but she does not. She control herself, and she give him the food. And not only that, more than this, then Rasulullah did dua to them, 9 different kids, all of them memorized. Actually, the hadith saying that they recite and memorize the Quran as the best. 9 of them. We ask Allah give us wives like that, say Ameen. And we ask Allah give us kids like that, say Ameen. أقول قولي هذا وأن الله أنتم مؤمنون. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. Another narration for رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم about also a very huge and big stone become like a sand. A big stone, they say, لا تعمل فيها أي معاول. There is no any axe can break anything of it, like a marble, very strong. And the axes cannot hit and cannot break even a little. They went to Rasulullah complained that we cannot do nothing with this one. Rasulullah said, bring to me some water. They bring. Rasulullah spit in it and he do some dua. Then he put the pours of water over that one. Then, فلما نضح الماء على تلك القضية يقول من حذرها فوالذي بعث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بالحق نبيا لنهالت الصخرة حتى عادت كالكثيب لا ترد فأسا ولا مسحة أبدا. He said, just Rasulullah did that, and he did the dua, then he put it upon it. No axe, no nothing. Itself. Become, did you ever see the sand when going down? The sand itself went like, if it is in high places, then it fell down. It was become like that. Impossible for even the machines right now, which it is a very strong and have high pressure and whatever, to do something like that. And Rasulullah does not do anything except the water, did dua, put it over it, it become like a sand in front of everyone. This is all of it miracles from Allah Azza wa Jal. To Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ. If you did not help him, not. If you did not defend Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the defend is, do not misunderstand, not killing if anyone, no. No, let whoever want to abuse Rasulullah, let him do whatever he want. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of him. But take care of your our own self by really following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're blaming others for insulting Rasulullah, while a lot of us, some they follow Sunnah of Rasulullah. But believe me, majority of the Muslim nowadays following bid'ah, following only just custom, far away from the Sunnah. Say to some people, this is Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wallahi, some of the Muslims they will look at it. For that, this is the real love of Rasulullah to follow him. The real defending of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not to go and kill anybody on behalf of his name. You will make the Muslim look bad everywhere. And other than this, not Allah, not Rasulullah say to anybody, I already mentioned to you too many situations. Never ever Rasulullah or Allah himself saying to anybody, kill anybody at all. But at the same time, take care of your own self and your own family by knowing the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and leaving your custom. A lot of things in our own days, just a custom. We take it from the others. Give you just example. Birthday for our own kids and birthday for Rasulullah. There is no in Islam anything like that. Do you love Rasulullah more than the Sahaba by making that birthday? No. If it is, either Allah will say, celebrate the birthday of Rasulullah. Allah never say. If it is, at least the Sahaba will do it to Rasulullah, and if he agrees that we have to do it. Birthday one day, you do it, and halwa, and gathering, and doing all kinds, then whole year forget about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam completely, which it is, they start with this one with a bid'ah. If it is, our own religion is waqf. Waqf means only what Allah said, only what Rasulullah said. You want to worship Allah according to His way. You want to really celebrate the birthday of Rasulullah? No Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No sunnah of Rasulullah. Learn it. Spend some of your time in order to learn. Then apply it in your life. This is the best of the celebration of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is a big sign of love. But only just by tongue and by eating halwa and gathering and naming that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did it well. But never ever. It's created by the politician for some of the reason. A long time since it goes on by on and on by on, from a country to a country, from Muslim to another Muslim. Same for our own kids. Some of the Muslim, I said to them, this is bid'ah. The Christian is on who do celebration of the birthday of their kids. Ya Rabbi, Ya A'udhu Billah, ask Allah save us. Ya who? You cannot imagine. How the answer? Oh, what's wrong with it? And you find him getting crazy. For what? Where it is? Another thing, imagine, Allah make it easy for you. Suppose you have 10 kids and born one in January, one in February. Then every month you will do celebration, inshallah, or you will lie. Allah make it easy for you. Do not do. And you are not accepting for your own self. Subhanallah. Allahumma gfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma arihna wa afrihna wa asturna wa la tafdahna. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سبب لمن اهتدى وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك يا رب العالمين. اللهم من مكر بنا فامكر به واجعل مكرهم يحيق بهم ويدمرهم تدميرا واجعل مكر أولئك هو يبور واجعل كيدهم في تضليل وتباب والبلاد والشجر والدواب منهم يا رب العالمين ومن شرورهم. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وجزاكم الله خيرا.